Hello all. So yesterday IFOA gave us this notification on CM2A guidance for answering September 2019 paper, and we are going to solve the September 2019 question paper, and we'll see as to what all questions are applicable in Word and we can do it efficiently in Word, and what are the questions that will require modification in this term. Everything is given in this, and we'll be elaborating in this video on every point which is given by the IFOA in this document. So this video is really helpful for those appearing for CM2 in September 2020 term, because this video will clear many doubts and queries which many students have. So I have highlighted some key areas in this document. The very first one here, it says that students will not be expected to learn to use the equation editor in the Word. So the equation editor or the mathematical typing which we were doing, using the equation editor in the Word will not be required at a great extent for answering your paper, CM2 paper, or any kind of a software which you were preparing if earlier, nor will they be permitted to paste in formula from another application. So this point solves many doubts of many students. First of all, aapko equation editor use karna nahi hai. You can just use it once or twice, but then it is absolutely not required for you to learn how to use an equation editor. If you have learned, very good, but now it is not required at all, because if you have learned kuch kharab nahi hua hai, you have an edge ki agar aapko kuch nahi samajh aaye ki kaise notation ke form mein kare, so your last resort should be using equation editor. That should be your last resort. Okay, so moving on, and also they have said that you all are not permitted to paste formulas from any. So many students were asking that if we have already the formulas are already there in the PDF or maybe in another Word document or in Excel, so can we just simply copy and paste it? No, that is not at all acceptable, and that will be like breaching the requirements of the IFOA. So that is not required, that is not permitted at all by the IFOA. They have clearly mentioned in this document. Okay, so moving on, we'll be solving September 2019 paper. I would suggest you all to just open the question paper. If not, you can just click on this link below, and every document which I am using now will be attached in my comment section below. So we'll start with the question number one. Without looking here, let me just go to the examiner's report. This is the examiner's report of September 2019 term, and the first, I'm not reading the question, so it will take a lot of time of yours in reading the question in the video. So I will expect you all to read the question on your own. Everything is attached in the comment section below. So here we have to show this entirely in the Word. Now this might seem really overwhelming at the beginning, but it's really simple how to write integral. I will just show you all. Let me do one thing, split my screen into two. So I'm just splitting my screen into two parts, and you all will be able to understand as to how to read all of this side by side. So IFOA is not expecting you all to write this entirely in form of integral, because that can only be done using the mathematical equation editor. But now we are not supposed to do that, so I'll be solving it without any use. This entire class will be without the use of mathematical or the equation editor, right? So moving on, how to write this. So first of all, let me just give the question number. Giving question number is very important. Also make sure you do everything in like every question, every answer should be in a new page. So if you're starting with question number one, complete entire question number one. Maybe it will take you one or two pages, and then when you start with the second question, move on to the next page. That makes your work really presentable, right? So the shortfall probability over here let me just increase the size of, so how to increase the size, home tab. I'll be making a quick video on all the shortcuts, on all the useful shortcuts in Word which will be required for you all, and also I will be taking quick class on various formatting which can be used while using the Word, right? So this infinity, you have to write INF, you have to write INF, and then I'm so sorry for that. INF will signify infinity. You can also write it in small letter, but I would suggest to write it in INF capitals. Then within the bracket, you specify the lower and the upper limit. So the lower limit is minus infinity and L. So minus infinity can be written as simply minus INF. Sorry, this should not be FT, right? Integral minus INF, which is minus infinity. You do not have to give the infinity symbol, and then straight away L. Do not forget this, that first it should be the lower limit, then should be the upper limit. If you write L comma minus infinity, then that will be read as integral from L to minus infinity, and which will fetch you a zero marks, right? So you have to make sure you write the lower limit first, then the upper limit. And integral INT is very simple. You just have to write INT. You do not have to give the integral sign. After this, what you do is you give the colon, and whatever is there within the integral has to be written after this colon sign which you have given. So it is fx dx, right? So this is how, you can give a space over here if you want to. This is how, and if you want to make it look more presentable, you can move on to the next line and just click on tab to indent this a bit. This is known as indenting. Using tab is known as indenting, and write it in the next line if you want to, right? This is the equation INT, then lower limit to upper limit, give the colon, and whatever is there within your integral has to be written in this, right? Moving on to the part B. Part B is also quite really simple over here, not much of an issue. So how to write this? One second, let me just, okay. So we'll write it B, the part B is given by, so here we are giving the formula for our value at risk, BRX. This can be normally written, this should be capital X. Do not forget to differentiate between a capital X and a small x, right? And then minus T, where I'm just showing you all, this is very simple, less than P is equal to small p. Do not make this error of using capital. Wherever you need to give capital P, wherever you need to give small p, make sure you're doing that. Or also, or you can write this entirely, this entire statement, right? Again, I'll show you all part C. Part C is very simple again. So how to do that? It says again, integral from minus infinity to mu. Now again, you do not have to give the symbol mu. If you want to, you can. I'll show you all both the ways. So whatever takes less of a time, we are going to do that. INF, and it goes to mu. So I'll just write a mu over here, and that is understood that mu is a mu. This, whatever I'm doing in this class, all of this is given by the IFOA notations document, which the IFOA released just a week ago. Then again the colon, and you'll write your entire equation again. So it's mu minus x. Remember to give a lot of spaces, a lot of brackets, and a lot of space in between. Do not be conjuice in giving spaces, because you are not wasting any paper. Remember that. Also, there should be a multiplication sign so that it is understood. For multiplication, I am using star sign. I am not using x. Otherwise, you will confuse yourselves. Even the examiner may be confused as to what you are meaning. And see, I have given one more bracket over here. to imply that fx is not multiplied with 2, but fx is multiplied with this entire thing, right? So for 2 to the power 2, we always give this caret sign. Do not use anything else. We are minimizing the use of equation editor and we want to make our work efficient and fast. So this is how we write it. For mu, if you do not want to write mu, what you can do is you can go to the insert tab. In the symbols section over here, you can select mu from more symbols. Just go on to more symbols. Go to the Greek alphabets over here. So I can just type in Greek, and so we have Greek. So in Greek, you will get mu. Just scroll down a bit and you'll get mu somewhere here, right? So just scroll down. I'll just again click on Greek letters, and somewhere over here you'll just have to find it a bit. And what you can also do, what I would also suggest you all to do, is to keep some of these, like mu, sigma, phi, and all of these which are required in CM2. What you all can do is you all can simply keep that in your recently used symbols, because once you use that, it comes here in the recently used symbols and it becomes easier for you all to understand, right? So let me just scroll down and see where the mu is. And here is mu. I'll just click on mu and I'll click on insert. So it's in Greek letters. I'll click on insert and you can see mu has been inserted over here. Once I delete this mu and move on to the next line, just click on the cross button, go to the symbols again, and then you'll see in here, you'll see mu to be the very first letter. These are the recently used symbols. So I would suggest you all keep some of the Greeks which are widely used, like mu, we have sigma, we have phi, we have many other symbols, some of the symbols which is widely used in CM2, so you can keep handy in the recently used symbols and you can just simply type it on. Or else they have accepted the use of writing mu, sigma in words. So both can be done. Do not hesitate in doing this, writing mu, you will get full marks. Make sure you are saving time wherever possible. So the second part does not need much of notation, usage of notations. This is a simple thing we can write. I'll show you all how to write this thing. Obviously, also this is very important. Some of the students, even I, sometimes forget to write these units. So it's very, very, very important that you give the currency symbols. Whatever unit is used, it's very important that you all use that. So here we have 90,000 pounds. Make sure you use the pound symbol. Do not miss this, otherwise your marks will be deducted. So I'll show you all how to write this. Very simple. Again, we'll go to the symbols insert tab in the symbols section. Symbols over here. I have already used this once, so it's there in my pound symbol is there in my recently used one. If you want to search for it, you can just type in currency over here. You can just simply type in currency symbols and you can find the pound symbol over here, right? So here, from here, you can just simply take it down, take any of the symbol you want to. Many currency symbols are here. I've already taken it down over here. I'll just click on this and insert. See, it's inserted in my word. I'll just now write 9,000. This is how you have to, you know, write these equations. This is not a big task. I'll show you all how to write this, which you see over here. It's very easy. So let me just show you all this one. It says X, capital X. Then we have this tilt sign. X follows normal 0.15 square. How to do this? Give the tilt sign. Where you find this tilt sign, it is above your tab key. In your keyboard, above the tab key, you will find the tilt sign, shift, and you just have to click on shift and that particular button which is there on top of your tab key, and then simply capital N 0.15 comma 0.15 square. So this is how you write your equation, very simple. I do not see anything new over here. Everything is very simple to be written in Word. Part 3 is pure theoretical question, full of words, no notation, no numerical notations required. So when we go back to the PDF given by the IFOA, it states how you can write the integral. This is the way we have followed it. Also, they say that you can write it in this form: integral from minus infinity to L. But I suggest that we use this one because this will take lot of less time than writing it entirely using integral from minus all of that. Instead of writing it integral from minus infinity to L, I think int minus infinity L will prove to be a shorter version of it. Moving to the second question, now over here, second question is what they are worried about over here, is what we were worried about earlier. Now it has been clarified by the IFOA. So the first part which you see is directly from the material. If you see, this is directly from the material. These wordings are directly from the material, the IFOA acted material which you have, or the PDF, whichever notes you use. This is the exact wording. This is a basically features and characteristics of the Brownian motion, standard Brownian motion. So what they have stated about this question is that this sort of direct examination of the core reading might be less common. So these sort of questions might not be there in your September 2020 paper, because these are the questions which will see, you will have, the students will have access to the core reading. They will have access to their own notes from October 2020 paper. So there will be a lot less chance of getting these sort of questions where you will have to give a definition or exact characteristics. So this sort of direct examination is very likely not to come in September 2020 examination or October 2020 examination, which you are going to have, right? The second and the third part over here is uses a lot of mathematical notations, but these, what you see, is not possible to write without the usage of mathematical editor. We can write this using the notations, but IFOA hasn't specified any notation for any direct notations for these kind of numerics which you see. So what they have stated, so basically these are the questions which IFOA will restrict giving in September 2020 paper, because even in the notations given by the IFOA, they haven't mentioned anything about how you can write these. So this is the exact PDF given by the IFOA, and over here we have f dash x, f double dash x, which can be written like this. We have del f by del s, which can be written as df by ds, stating partial if necessary. So also for the double differentiation, we have del d to the power 2f, and like this we can write the equation, this equation. So these equations you can write simply because it is given by the IFOA. But how to write yt, how to write dbt, this is not given by the IFOA in the notations stated. What I have felt as to how we can do this is by simply writing y and that then give a colon and then write t. So I'll just show you all quickly how we can do this. This is question number 2. So I'm not moving on to the next sheet, but I would suggest you all to do so in the examination, right? We have the first part. We are solving the first part. no, we are solving the second part basically. So yeah, so in the second part, the first part I'm not solving over here. If you want to, this is very simple. You, what you have over here is b t minus s. So you all can write b and then simply t minus b, just give some spaces in between, b s, right? And to give this arrow over here, I'll show you all how to do this, but IFOA has stated that this kind of question will not be asked. To give this arrow sign, we'll go to the insert tab. So let me just extend this. In the insert tab, we have, in the illustrations, we have shapes, right? So in the shapes, we have this arrow symbol. So I'll just select this and draw the arrow sign. You can change the color to black from the shape format which opens up, and over here you can simply, what you need to do is just give spaces to move on to the left right side of it. This follows T. So this is how you can write this entirely. I do not see anything new. BR, BR. Now how to write less than equal to, okay, so this I'll show you all how to do this. Even if it turns out there in the examination paper, so you all know, do not worry as to how to write this. It's very simple. I'll just show you all. Curly brackets, and we have b r, where r is less than equal to, so for that you can write less than equal to s. This is what IFOA has given in the notations PDF, so no worries at all. And I've also showed you all how we can write normal 0, t minus s, very simple, just like this. Nothing new which I see in part 1. In part 2, this entire equation, if you have seen my earlier 3 videos on mathematical typing, I'm sure you will be able to solve this entirely using the mathematical editor. If you're not able to use this partial differentiation sign, you can simply use df by dx, and you all can mention it after everything in the right hand side as given by the IFOA, as stated by the IFOA. You all can state that partial differentiation, we are differentiating it partially. So in the bracket or in the beginning, you can write partially differentiating, and then you can give this entirely without even giving the partial differentiation sign. You can give just simply df by dx. Now how to write yt without the use of mathematical editor? See, if you use mathematical editor, I'll show you all, this can be written as capital Y underscore, and we write p, and you get yt. But this is not we are doing now, because this is prohibited. Like, you have to minimize the use of mathematical editor. So what we are going to do is y, give a colon and give t. This is what I have understood after reading the notations notations PDF given by IFOA. They haven't mentioned it directly, but you can do this. Also, how to write this, again, you can do y and just take this within the bracket and give a colon and t. So I think this is what is acceptable, but again, this is a place of doubt which arises. So what I'll do is I'll just write it down to the IFOA. We can mail to the IFOA regarding how to write these equations, right? This we can do definitely. But what they have stated in the PDF which is released recently, they have stated that, I've just underlined it, that this question contains too much of algebra to be answered in Word. In order to adapt these questions in Word, a multiple choice question can be asked. So what they can do, instead of giving it directly, maybe they'll give you 4 equations, this sort of 4 equation, and will ask you which is correct equation, right? This can also be done. Also, what can be done is the question could cite the generic formula and require candidates to state the key parameters. So what they can do, they can just give the, instead of writing at or y square t, instead of doing that, what you can, they can do, they can just give it in the generic form, and then they can ask you about the different parameters. So that can also be done. Also, it can be in the form of MCQ. So they have stated that these kind of questions where you require a lot of algebraic expressions, this is not what is expected to produce in Word by the IFOA, and these questions will be restrained ऐसे क्वेश्चंस नहीं आएंगे आपके सितंबर 2020 एग्जामिनेशन में, तो ऐसे इक्वेशन देख के आपको आई थिंक नहीं घबराना चाहिए, क्योंकि अभी IFO ने क्लियरली बोल दिया है कि ऐसा चीज़ नहीं आएगा. आएगा भी तो हम उसको MCQ के फॉर्म में लेंगे, या फिर हम दे देंगे इक्वेशन एंड हम उससे उसके ऊपर आपसे क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं. ठीक है, तो हम डायरेक्टली आपको नहीं बोलेंगे ऐसा इक्वेशन टाइप करने के लिए. सिमिलरली दे हैव सेड द सेम थिंग फॉर पार्ट 3. सो इन पार्ट 3, ऑल्दो दिस पार्ट 3 कैन बी काइंड ऑफ रिटन इन वर्ड, जैसे आप इसको कैसे लिख सकते हो, DF. आई जस्ट शो यू ऑल अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ इट. सो यू कैन जस्ट राइट DF एंड इन ब्रैकेट यू विल राइट P, कैपिटल XT, एंड दिस इक्वल टू 4 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय यू हैव T² सो T² एंड देन अगेन यू हैव मल्टीप्लीकेशन अगेन फॉर एक्सपोनेंशियल वी राइट TXP. दिस इज गिवन बाय द IFO इन इट्स नोटेशंस. वी राइट गिव एम्पल अमाउंट ऑफ स्पेसिस, डू नॉट डू कंजूसी इन गिविंग स्पेसिस एंड XT. सो दिस इंटायरली आई थिंक यू कैन राइट इट डाउन. अगेन वी हैव YT. सो हाउ टू राइट YT, आई वुड सजेस्ट वी कैन गो यूजिंग दिस अप्रोच ऑफ वॉट आई हैव डन हेयर फॉर XT. वी कैन राइट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय YT मल्टीप्लाइड बाय DBT. सो हेयर यू कैन राइट दिस. ओके, सो दिस इज अ जनरल अप्रोच. इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग कोलन, इंस्टेड ऑफ फॉलोइंग दिस मेथड, यू कैन ऑल्सो फॉलो दिस मेथड, विच आई थिंक इज मोर कन्वीनियंट, मोर सूटेबल वे ऑफ अप्रोचिंग इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग कोलन. ओके, सो लेट मी रिमूव दिस. इफ यू ऑल हैव एनी डाउट, सो लेट मी जस्ट रिमूव दिस. यू कैन गो थ्रू दिस अप्रोच, इट लुक्स रियली नीट एंड रियली नाइस. एग्जैक्टली सेम थिंग इज देयर, नथिंग न्यू. हेयर वी हैव प्लस हाफ, सो इंस्टेड ऑफ गिविंग 1/2 यू कैन ऑब्वियसली राइट 0.05. 0.05 मल्टीप्लाइड 0.5 सॉरी 0.5 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 16 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय, डू नॉट फर्गेट टू गिव एम्पल अमाउंट ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन साइन. सो इफ़ यू आर राइटिंग, लेट मी शो यू ऑल दिस एज वेल. इफ़ यू ऑल आर राइटिंग दिस पोर्शन, ओके आई शो यू ऑल दिस पोर्शन. इफ यू ऑल आर राइटिंग दिस पोर्शन 0.5, do not forget to give this multiplication 16 multiplication t^4 again multiplication exponential and then entirely whatever is there within it. So do not skip these, because if you write half in bracket then again open a bracket 16, it becomes really confusing. What I have understood, what I have followed in all the 4 papers, what I have seen is that they are using constantly multiplication sign. They are using cross, they are using X as multiplication in replacement of multiplication sign or the star sign. But you can use star sign as well, which is given by the IFOE notations PDF recently released. The part 3 question is also kind of really theoretical, not much of algebra required, but I'll show you all this as well. Let me move on to the second page, and increase the size a bit. So we have the third part, question 3, and in this, how to write this, I'll show you all. We have 1 plus IT, you can write it like this, there is no other option, or you all can give a colon sign as well, right? Both are feasible. And then here we have for this T greater than equal to 1. This is how you write this equation. Again, here we have something as mu and sigma written. Mu and sigma, they have stated, you can write mu instead of capital. Yeah, it can be capital, not an issue. Sigma, or again go to the insert symbol section over here. In the Greek letters you will find mu, which is already used, so it's there in the recently used ones. When you go to the Greek symbols, when you just type over here GRE, you go to the Greek symbols, and in here you will be able to find your sigma somewhere, right? So you will be able to find your sigma from here, and then you can just insert it so that it becomes easier for you. Or you can use the sigma, you can just simply write sigma even if you're not able to find it. We have sigma square, so yeah, definitely you can write it like this, sigma square. Not an issue at all, you'll get full marks. Again, over here we have exact same thing, so let me just show you all how to do this as well. We'll write log, within the bracket we'll write capital V N. You all could have written it like this as well, not an issue. I would suggest giving brackets, it becomes really neat, right? Then we have minus log 1 plus IT again. Now this IT you cannot do without you can't go to the subscript. Yeah, you can go to the subscript by using a shortcut key. I'll show you all what is the shortcut. The shortcut key is control equal to sign basically. Control equal to will give you this subscript. Will give you this subscript and you can write simply one. Again, to go back to the normal, control plus. Let me show you all another way to do this. Control plus is one way. The next way to do this, so wherever you are able to copy paste the equation, what was the equation? Let me just go back to the answer. Okay, this was the equation. So here we have a minus sign. Minus, we'll simply copy this entirely. Okay, we'll copy this entirely, and instead of 1 over here we have n. We have n. How to do this again? I'll show you all. I control equal to, which is the shortcut key, and 1. Or again control equal to, go back to the normal. Or in the home tab you will find it over here in the font section. I then suppose write 1 and then select this and click on this subscript. You can see the shortcut within the bracket, control plus equal to, and see how you turn it back. So this is how also you could have done your previous XT and YTs, but it takes a lot of time, you know. Yeah, you can use the shortcut key control plus, but when you're typing at a really fast speed, it takes time. So they haven't suggested doing this. I would suggest, yeah, you can do this. You can take this approach, not an issue at all. You can again over here also could have done it. Just select this letter and click on this, or use the shortcut key control equal to. For the superscript, we have control shift plus sign. Okay. What they have written about question number 3 is that again you can use sigma instead of writing, instead of using mathematical editor, or you can insert symbol if you want to, just as I showed you all. Question 4 is again the entire theoretical, just simple typing. So it's very important to improve your typing speed. Now in question 5, you have the binomial tree. This binomial tree, what they have suggested, do not use arrow symbols. It will take a lot of time to do that. So what they have stated is that you can use for payoff trees, what you can do is you can simply set out it in tables or simply in plain text, as long as it is sufficiently clear. This is what you have to do. You have to make your solution clear. Two things, either tables or in form of plain text. What do I mean by plain text? Is this the solution which you see? This is a plain text, like 80. But I suggest that using plain text becomes sometimes difficult. And so using tables is a better option to do. So I'll show you all in my word how to do this. First of all, this is question number 5. So we have, remove this, and we have question number 5. The very first equation, I'll show you all how to type this. Q equal to e to the power r. If you all are finding my videos a little slow, what you all can do is you can simply increase the speed. I am going very, very slow for the people who are using Word for the very first time. E to the power 0.05 minus, just see the confidence when you will type, you know, just get that confidence in yourselves. 1.1 minus 0.9. Writing your numericals is very, very, very important. If you think that you all can skip this step, if you all think you all can skip this step and straight away after writing this, you all can just give this answer, I'm so sorry, you'll not get the full marks. You'll have to write this. You'll have to write this. Okay. Now I'll show you all how to construct a payoff tree. After this, give a space, go to the insert tab. In the insert, we have tables. Select the number of rows and columns. So over here, what I see is 1, 2, 3 columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. So let me create 1, 2, 3. Just simply select. And we have 3 rows and 5 columns. See? So simple. And now I will fill up the values in here. If you want to decrease the size, like if you all desire to decrease the size, just simply take your cursor over here and it will decrease the size. You can select the entire table also and decrease the size. Okay, this can be done, not wasting much of a time on this. Do not do that. We have 80. We have using the arrow keys. Okay, I'm using the arrow keys. I'm not using my mouse. Restrain using on mouse. Jitna kam mouse use karoge, utna acha hai. We have 79.2 and see how easy it becomes. 96. I think using table is more convenient than going through than using your, see, decrease the size. And once this is done, for the rest of the tables, you can simply copy paste this table which you have already created, because you have decreased the size and all. You have done so much of mehnat yahan pe. So baad ke liye aap kya kar sakte ho, isi ko directly aap copy paste kar sakte ho, right? Isme kaam karte hain, isko thoda bold banate hain hum, taki samajhne mein easy ho. Let me make it bold, increase the font size. Yeah, see? Legible. So you'll have to write stock price tree yahan pe. This is your question part 1. So you'll have to write part 1 stock price tree and then you give this tree. You'll get your full marks. Full marks will be allotted to you. Okay. Payoff tree yahan pe khali ek column hai. What I can do is I can simply copy this entire table. Theek hai? Table fir se nahi banana humko. Paste karenge. And fir hum kya karenge na? ये या तो आप इसको सिलेक्ट कर सकते हो ऐसे करके, आई एम सो सॉरी फॉर दैट, सिलेक्ट करके बैक स्पेस प्रेस करो, सिलेक्ट करके पूरे को सिलेक्ट करके बैक स्पेस प्रेस करो एंड यहाँ पे फिर आप फिल कर सकते हो अपने टेबल को सिंपली. ठीक है, जितने चीज़ आपको नहीं चाहिए सिलेक्ट करो, बैक स्पेस प्रेस करो, ऐसे करके यू कैन जस्ट सिंपली सी. बैक स्पेस प्रेस करने से आराम से आपका सेल्स कॉलम डिलीट हो जाएगा. यहाँ पर अगेन यू कैन राइट 21.8. और आपको अगर टेबल साइज इंक्रीज करना है, सपोज आप यहाँ पे हो, आपको एक और रो ऐड करना है, तो आप क्या क्लिक करोगे? टैब. क्लिक ऑन द टैब की टू मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट रो. ऑलवेज क्लिक ऑन द टैब की. जैसे आप एक नॉर्मल यूज करते हो टेबल में, वैसे आप यहाँ पे यूज कर सकते हो. बार बार टैब की पे क्लिक करके यू कैन मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट रो अगेन एंड अगेन, राइट? नॉट एन इशू एट ऑल. सिंपली आपको टैब की, देखो टैब की प्रेस करने से सेकेंड में आ गए सेल में, टैब की वापस टैब की प्रेस किया तो दूसरे रो में आ गए. ऐसे करके सिंपली यू विल हैव टू डू इट. एंड द वैल्यू ओवर हियर विच यू सी, अगेन यू कैन जस्ट राइट इट डाउन सिंपली 21.8. इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस क्रॉस यू कैन यूज द स्टार साइन, यू कैन यूज द एक्स फ्रॉम योर कीबोर्ड, नॉट एन इशू. ये पूरा लिख के टू दी पार कैरेट सिंबल 2. यहाँ पे मुझे कुछ नया नहीं दिख रहा. दिस इज़ नॉट एक्स, तो ना बहुत जन कन्फ्यूज हो जाते हैं कि इज दिस इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन साइन और इज दिस इज एक्स. आप आराम से, आपके ऊपर डिपेंड करते हैं, आप दोनों यूज़ कर सकते हो. आप सिंपल, मैं दिखाती हूँ, यू कैन यूज़ दिस, यू कैन यूज़ दिस साइन, राइट? यू कैन, सो सॉरी फॉर दैट, यू कैन you can use this sign, which is your multiplication sign given by the IFOA, star sign, or you can use this X, right? Dono aap use kar sakte ho, not an issue. So this was your fifth question. Again, यहाँ पे भी मुझे कुछ नया नहीं दिख रहा. 1000, मेक श्योर वापस आप बीच में मल्टीप्लिकेशन साइन यूज़ करो. ई टू दी पार ये पूरा है ना, तो आप इसको कैसे लिखेंगे? इसको आप ऐसे लिख सकते हो, देखो 1000 स्टार एक्सपोनेंशियल एंड ब्रैकेट में लिखा 2 × 0.05, ठीक है, ये आप लिख सकते हो. और व्हाट यू कुड डू इज 1000 e to the power and then bracket में पूरा चीज़ लिखा. Both is acceptable, both are given by the IFOA notations. Both आप ऐसे भी कर सकते हो, दोनों चीज़ acceptable है, ठीक है. आई सी नो न्यू इक्वेजन ओवर हेयर. वापस आप एक, आई वुड सजेस्ट जहाँ पे भी ट्री, पे ऑफ ट्री, बायनोमियल ट्री, कुछ भी बनाना हो ना, हमेशा यूज़ करो टेबल, एकदम आराम से बिंदास टेबल यूज़ करो, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, ठीक है. वी हैव दिस इक्वेजन, अगेन द सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ एन इक्वेजन विच आई सी ओवर हियर, सो नॉट एन इशू एट ऑल. आराम से इसको यूज़ करो, नॉट एन इशू एट ऑल, ठीक है. दिस वॉज योर इंटायर क्वेश्चन 5. हाउ वी रोट इट इन वर्ड, वी यूज टेबल्स फॉर आर पे ऑफ, ठीक है. ये दोनों हमें नहीं चाहिए तो हम इनको बैक स्पेस करके डिलीट करेंगे, ठीक है. हमने कैसे टेबल इंसर्ट किया, हमने कैसे एरो साइन इंसर्ट किया, हमने कैसे डिफरेंट नोटेशंस लिखे, हमने कैसे सबस्क्रिप्ट यूज़ किया, कंट्रोल इक्वल टू साइन यूज, शॉर्टकट यूज़ करके, या फिर इन द होम टैब वी हैव दिस सबस्क्रिप्ट का सिम्बल. तो ऐसे कैसे हमने इंटीग्रल सॉल्व किया, ये हमारा 5 क्वेश्चंस था. इन आर नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल बी सॉल्विंग द नेक्स्ट 5 क्वेश्चंस, राइट. सो रिमेंबर, मेक श्योर यू कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग अ लॉट. वट एवर इफ आई स्किप, आई विल बी कंप्लीटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ इक्वेशंस, लॉट ऑफ नोटेशंस. इफ आई स्किप एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी नोटेशन विच यू फील लाइक, यू कैन जस्ट कमेंट दैट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन बिलो. थैंक यू सो मच.